God never gives someone a gift they aren't capable of receiving. So, if He gives us the gift of Christmas, it means we all have the ability to understand and receive it. With this quote by Pope Francis and Ilakshi Kaur, on behalf of the entire Vincentian family, wish you all a very Merry Christmas. No wonder this year's celebration is like none other. No inclusivity of all of us together in the school, no fun in the zero periods, no setting of the wrong show for the skit, and of course, no muffins at the end of the celebrations. On a heavy note, there's nothing same. The night before Christmas, when on every child's mind was, if Santa would be here, would he be wearing a mask? Would the reindeers be distanced, or would there be sanitized gifts? A tale that sounds tragic, a pandemic Christmas. But here's a message. There's nothing to fear, nothing to worry. Christmas would come, there'd be joy, there'd be fun, no need to be glum. We celebrate Christmas to remember the birthday of Lord Jesus Christ, the Messiah of the people, who taught them to always follow the path of goodness. So, there'd be no special way or there'd be no better way to celebrate today's special day than by thanking Him indebtedly for having been with us all through these tough times. More than 2 millennia ago, the angel Gabriel had appeared in front of Mary and had told her that she'd be giving birth to a baby boy who'd be called as the Son of God. Christ was born in the town of Bethlehem, and His birth changed history forever. That God sent His only Son in this world to die for us and save us from the clutches of Satan, thus prolificating everlasting peace to this humanity. I take this opportunity to wish you again a very Merry Christmas and a prosperous New Year, and also to a holistically new way of celebrating this year's Christmas. Let's begin.
Prabhu Yesu Naam Pukari, Prabhu Yesu Naam Pukari, Yesu Naam. not just a temporary celebration or the memory of a beautiful event. Christmas is more. Christmas is an encounter, says Pope Francis. First and foremost, I wish you all a Merry Christmas. On this auspicious occasion of Christmas, we celebrate it in a different mode due to COVID-19. I wish and pray that let this holy festival bring with it the joy and peace to start a new journey of righteous living and a successful thriving. Let this Christmas wash away the coronavirus from this world. On this day, full of light, the prophetic proclamation resounds, for to us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government will be upon his shoulder, and his name will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Isaiah chapter 9 verse 6. The power of this child, Son of God and Son of Mary, is not the power of this world based on might and wealth, but it is the power of love. It is the power which created the heavens and earth, which gives life to all creation, to minerals, plants and animals. It is a force which attracts man and woman and made them one flesh, one single existence, and transforms evil into good. It is the power of God. This power of love led Jesus Christ to strip himself of his glory and to become man. It led him to give his life on the cross and to rise from the dead. It is the power of service which inaugurates in our world the kingdom of God, a kingdom of justice and peace. For this reason, the birth of Jesus was accompanied by the angels' song as they proclaimed, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace among men with whom he is pleased." Luke chapter 2 verse 14. On this pious moment, let the spirit of Christmas inspire and delight us all. May all the sweet magic of Christmas conspire to gladden your heart and fulfill every longing desire. Christmas celebration infuses exuberant and trustful joy into mankind. In Jesus, we find the fulfillment of all the prophecies and the culmination of the expectation of the age-old waiting. He is one true God, God of Abraham, Isaac and Jacob. He is the God who comes to us, visit us, who comes to dwell among us and to stay with us. He comes to free us from evil tendencies and death, and from all that prevents our true happiness, God comes to save us. The coming of Christ and his presence among us as one of us give us reason to live in hope that the divine light will shatter the darkness within us and around us and liberate us from our fears and prejudices and never leave us alone. Jesus must be born in our hearts and lives during this Christmas season and every day of our lives through the sharing of our love, our act of kindness, mercy and forgiveness. We are called to be witnesses of God's love by the love we extend to others, witnesses of his justice by our unfailing commitment to what is right and good, witnesses of his forgiveness by our mercy and compassion, and a harvesters of souls through a humble and dedicated servanthood. Hence, let us channelize this great gift and propel a new hope in the people around us by caring for those in need, giving them his peace and turning the other cheek when we are provoked, giving his love by encouraging those who are discouraged and disheartened in life, and giving them joy by strengthening and helping those who feel at the end of their strength, showing them that we care and that God cares as well. Remember that we are the bearers of the new life and hope the little babe of Bethlehem brings to mankind. Therefore, carry the unconditional love, tenderness and forgiveness of God to those who grow weary and feel the way to sinfulness or disappointments and help them to move forward to the fullness of life the Lord offers. May the Christmas season be a time for bringing hope and transformation to our very self, and it may enable us to enjoy the fruits of Christmas, that is love, peace and joy. Wishing you all the joy, peace and lasting hope of Christmas and a blessing filled New Year 2021. God bless you.
Thank you. Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy Christmas.